Little Six. Little Six. Trapped down in the depths of the maw. Certainly no longer the darkest depths, but without a doubt, depths just as vast. Such is your fate. But we haven't forgotten about you. Oh no, we have not. We are going to save you, to protect you with our thoughts, Little Six, to allow you to reach the surface once more where you belong. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, it has been some time, but a mellow greetings, good day, and welcome back to the gluttonous world of Let's Play Little Nightmares. When we last left off, we certainly left the prison behind ourselves. But not just the prison, also the children, dad, giant, the caretaker, I suppose, and the watchful eyes. It was a place of dread, certainly, but now we are here, wherever here is supposed to be. But anywhere is better than the prison, am I correct? One step closer to freedom. But we mustn't give up now. That was only the first hurdle. No doubt, it is going to get much, much worse, much, much more treacherous. Alright, there is another walkway over yonder, but there is just no possibility at all that we are going to reach it anytime soon. Not from here. Good lord. The vastness. It keeps being intimidating. But thankfully there appears to be another stairway in the back, going upward. Well, upward toward the surface is certainly better than going down. Shall we, Little Six? Yes, indeed. We shall. My, oh my, what a mystery. I just don't understand it, the existence of these walkways, because they have the perfect size for her. But why are they here? Who built them? I have got a couple of assumptions, but no idea which of those could be true. Perhaps the giants themselves built them for their prisoners? I don't know. Perhaps the gnomes built them? Questionable. Or perhaps the maw itself created them, because it is a sentient being? Oh dear, I am still not a fan of that theory. But who knows, who knows? There is definitely a door up there. A passageway, rather, and we are going to approach it now. Oh dear, don't fall. For the love of God, do not fall. Alright. Alright, alright. That certainly worked. No traps thus far. No danger in sight. But that might soon change. I doubt that we are completely alone. Now, what could be through there? Hello, hello, hello. Just a small office? Apparently. A desk, a chair, but look at that. I can see you. Down there, below the desk, there is a gnome hiding. I cannot state enough how happy I feel whenever I see them. Those guys are my only friends down here in the depths of the maw. All right, no doubt he is going to be afraid, but we have got a cure for that, don't we? All right, you can certainly try to run, but you are not going to escape my hacks. Now then, is there anything else before we proceed, like a collectible? I could try to climb these, maybe. Ugh, a black stain on the floor. That certainly brings back memories of nasty, nasty critters that lurk in the dark. I don't like it. Now why is there a big stain here? Oh my! Now, this was actually not what I thought was going to happen. A secret passage. Wow. The mall is just full of surprises. What did I expect to happen? Nothing, actually. Nothing at all. But that is a pressure plate. Damn. Alright, you have got my attention. More. You have got it all. Nothing else, though, nothing else. How do we keep it open? I wonder, perhaps that chair is going to be of use. Another chair that is going to serve us well. But first, yep, I'm gonna climb onto the desk. There's a mug, such a small mug. It is quite adorable, but the desk right here, its size, certainly made for a giant. But why is there such a small mug? I don't get it. Here's a lamp though, or lantern, let us ignite it. There. Certainly doesn't illuminate the darkness much, but it is a start. Alright. Nothing else up here? Nothing at all. Careful now, Six. Can I climb these, perhaps? I can open them. And that means there might be something up there. Alright, but not in the next one. Not giving up yet. Ugh. But now, I am going to surrender myself. Can't work with those. Alright, about that gnome, where did you go? Do you happen to own another secret chamber that is your home? Sorry to intrude, I am so sorry, but you need to be hugged. It is your destiny. Come on now, Six. Grab the chair. Nope. Like this. Oh boy, that thing certainly is heavy. But we can make it work. Push it. Alright. The very first secret of this chapter. Welcome back to the second chapter, by the way, because this is certainly it. Alright, reveal your secrets to us all. Oh, I see. It is inside the cabinet. The huge cabinet, if you will. Can I open this? Certainly. Did you ever doubt Six's strength? Oh, please. Hello? What have we here? Oh my. I don't know if you can see it, but over there on the wall is a massive, massive eyeball. Well, not like an actual eyeball, but it looks like an eye that is closed. Is that just decoration? Or am I in for something bad? Also, like a console with a button in the middle of the room. This room must have a special purpose. Should I press that button? Well, first we are going to hug the gnome. Don't you run away now from me. Oh, come on. And he is gone again. He escaped back into the first room. Alright, I'll be back in a second, but first... I can't say I like this. Standing in front of this massive apparatus. Cause it might be that, a giant apparatus, that I am about to activate. Oh dear Six, should we? Hopefully nobody is going to notice this. Hopefully this is going to assist us. Oh dear, brace yourselves. Oh my god. That is the bedroom with all of those children. Alright, hold on. Are you telling me this is like a surveillance room? And I am currently observing the footage of the cameras? Oh dear. My god. Security certainly is tight within the mall. But this is creepy. Can you imagine one of the giants just standing here and observing the children sleeping? The prisoners? I was in there. If it is supposed to be the same room, who knows how many there might be. Alright, nothing happening though. Anything else? Gnomes. And so many of them. I can see 3 in total. Alright, I don't know where that might be. Looks like some sort of small storage space once again. And like a hatch over on the right. I wish I could hug them all, but this is creepy. I mean, are the gnomes feeling safe right now? But this camera device could just be watching them the whole time? Oh my god, within the mall, nobody is safe. What the hell? What the hell is that? Do you see it? Over on the left. I can see a face. That is without a doubt a giant. Is he sleeping or something? It looks like another storage room. I think I can see food. Like apples and sausages. Perhaps a kitchen of sorts? I don't know, but that is creepy. I am just gonna move on. Yeah, just gonna move on with my life. Oh dear. And this looks sort of fancy. A stairway? Purple walls? Pictures on them? And what is that sound? Is that somebody... somebody humming a tune? Sounds like it. Oh dear. I was hoping this would answer some questions. But now I just got more than originally. Amazing. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. I remember that silhouette. Just gently stroking her hair, sitting in front of a broken mirror and humming away. There is also a doll, And I was right. Those dolls, they represent her. Oh dear, I shouldn't be watching this. I've got a bad feeling. And that is apparently all I am allowed to see. Well, well, what to make of it all? That woman. She was the lady from our vision, our little nightmare, from the beginning of the journey. And then Six awakened. Why did she have a nightmare about her? Who is that woman? She was sitting in a chair, just humming, feeling happy. Could she be, perhaps, someone important? Somebody in charge of the Maw? She certainly didn't look as disturbing as the other giants I've encountered thus far. A lone chair. And there's a massive, massive door. I suppose giants would enter this room through it. But I found a secret passageway. Intriguing. Who made it? The giants as well? I don't know. But it looks like there is nothing else. Alright. You can certainly craft your own theories, ladies and gentlemen. But right now, I certainly haven't gained anything new of value. I just need to move on and escape before they find us. Now, about that gnome. My friend, where have you gone? Come on now, don't be shy. You cannot escape the Hux forever. Over here? No. Is he just gone? My friend, don't hide. Huh. This is certainly strange. Wait a second. Alright, before we continue, I am just going to close this up again. Don't want anybody to be in the know that I was here. Alright. It was slightly ajar. That is fine. There. Now nobody should notice. Hopefully. But the gnome is gone. Alright, I don't know. Perhaps he is still in there. Or did he leave this room as well? I am going to search for a second. I would hate to move on without delivering a hug. Aha! Just running away, eh? If that's the game you wish to play, I want to be up there as well, so it's gonna work out just fine. Moving on. Ugh, what bizarre architecture. Giant rooms, but such small stairways. Good lord, where am I? And there is another door. Ah, and this massive, massive shaft. Can't open this one. But where's the gnome? Aha, I have got you now. You can't run away anymore. But soon you shall witness that I've got a kind heart, and I just want to share it with you. Aww. There. You couldn't see it. But you could certainly feel it. Ah, isn't that charming? And thus, we have obtained another friend. Unfortunately, well, he isn't going to be a part of this journey for long, but I appreciate the comfort. Nothing over here. Just like some random items, and that is it. Can certainly climb them, but nothing else. Oh dear, that was a bit loud. Careful now. Well, I have to say goodbye, my friend. Ladies and gentlemen, perhaps it would interest you to know that thus far we haven't missed a single gnome. Also, thus far, we haven't missed a single statue. The statues that can be broken. Isn't that lovely? Alright, my friend, you can follow me up the final stairway if you wish to, but after that, we have to part ways, unfortunately. Nope, not gonna follow. Well, be safe then. Be safe and be careful, most importantly. A bucket to catch some water? Sure, that's gonna work. And a door. I don't think we can open this, but what have we here? An open hatch? Certainly. Or shaft? Whatever. I'm gonna climb that and see whatever fun awaits beyond. Whatever fun. Oh dear. Hello? More gnomes. That is good. Where there are gnomes, it must be safe and secure, correct? Oh my. What kind of room have I found myself in? Oh my god. Oh dear. Oh Jesus Christ. Look at how tall the furniture happens to be. Look at the furniture. Yeah, this... In her eyes, little sexist eyes, this is like a mountain range. Damn. I bet we'll have to climb those. No doubt about it. Alright, where did that gnome go? Oh, seriously? You think you can fool me? This must be another secret wall. One that you can turn or something by pushing it. But there is also a lever, a switch, you know. Something is going to open that, but what exactly? A suitcase? Up there is a sink, and above the sink a picture. A picture of a strange fella. What is up with that hat? He is certainly wearing kind of a fancy hat, but the hat itself? It looks wrong. It looks like part of his skin is missing. Hopefully that isn't meant to be like foreshadowing. Any gnomes hiding? I don't think so. There's just like a big bottle here. And a toilet, but nothing else. Yeah, we might be able to climb those drawers, oh dear. But don't fall. First, however, I would like to check up on my friend, because I am certain that you can open this with enough determination. Aha. You thought you could hide, just like your friend down below. Actually, I should be careful. This is not very inviting. Ugh, I remember the last dark location, and suddenly it was raining down leeches. Hello? Now what is this? How bizarre. A random box with like a jar on top? Is this supposed to be art? Damn, that's deep. Hello, my friend? Ooh, a lock. This is certainly locked. What's behind it? I am feeling intrigued. This must be important, but a key is required. Six, can't you just like grab it and tear it off? No. She is powerful, but not that powerful. Alright. Guess we are looking for a key then. But where did the gnome go? Perhaps hiding behind this wall? Careful now. Don't close it all the way. Well, at least there's a handle. We would be able to open it up again. Nope. That gnome is just gone. They know this place inside out. But I don't. Alright, now what should we do? I think we might be able to push the suitcase. And then we can reach that switch. However, before we do that, I'm just gonna climb this and see if anything can be found up above. Sure. Careful now, Six, careful now. Aha. What is that? Oh, Christ almighty. Just like pants? Hanging up there? Just pants? Certainly. Ugh, but the way they came into view, that was a bit eerie. Ugh, it's the size of everything that's getting to me. But over there's the key. How do we get there? Lots of random stuff everywhere. But nothing else. My god. How would you even get the stuff up there? You can't. You can't get it up there. You would have to be so tall. Or, I don't know. Your limbs would have to be very long. Oh no. Oh dear no. The caretaker. Could it be that he lives here? Nah, impossible. He is down below, taking care of the children. He wouldn't be here, no. Ugh, maybe there is another creature with long limbs. Why should he be the only one? Oh goody. While we are here, should we have some fun? Sometimes it is easy to forget how innocent little Six is. Just throwing a ball back and forth. Just jumping all over the place. I am just a child. Yes, indeed. A child trapped in the most bizarre of wonderlands. Ugh, I ate the wrong cake, presumably. And I can't find the remedy to get back into full size. Maybe that is it. Alright, you must help us. For a second I thought we might be able to use it to reach higher places, but no. Alright, there, grab the handle, and now you're coming with us. Ugh, there. Don't get squished. That should be enough. But what is it going to do? Like, what could this switch possibly do that would allow us to get up there? What the hell? What the hell was that? I'm sorry, what? That is not good. I don't mind the noises the gnomes make, but that was most definitely not a gnome noise. Oh shit. We shouldn't linger. The times of fun are suddenly over. That isn't good. Could you stop? Could you stop with the noises? First, like, a dragging sound? That might have just been, I don't know, The ghost. The ghost of the suitcase that I just, dragged over there. But those other noises. That was certainly somebody moving around somewhere. Oh shit. I can't linger, I mustn't linger, so this switch right here, it activated a bed. Thank you. Nice and comfy. And now we can climb even more. Careful now. There are pictures of gnomes over there. Plenty of pictures. In fact, these pictures, they happen to be quite intriguing. Look at that one, like a stairway going upward toward the light. What do they mean? Ugh, but that fella over there. He looks somewhat familiar. In fact, I couldn't see him very well back then because it was so dark. But that might actually be a picture of the caretaker? But what is up with that head? What is up with his skin? I don't wish to meet him again. No. Oh, Christ almighty. Don't fall. My god, don't fall. Oh, goody, here is another leap of faith. Isn't that amazing? Oh, Six, be careful now. Oh dear. Alright, like this we can reach the key. But is there anything else up there? Can I get up there? Oh god. Ugh, I am sorry, Six, for making you do this, but... Aha! There is the first hidden statue of this chapter. It was worth it coming up here. And now you shall be, shall be shattered. Yeah. Oh dear. Also knocked down a toilet roll, but I don't care. Yeah. Ugh, this is so terrifying. Yeah. Ah, oh god. I accidentally broke a bottle. Oh Jesus Christ. Those shards. Must be huge. Six, are you alright? Oh shit. Accidentally grabbed that. Didn't mean to break it. We should really go. There it is. A giant key. Good lord. Let me just throw that down first. How much more noise could you possibly make? At least this was a soft drop. And now we are just going to quickly leave before that door opens, revealing something horrible. I am just leaving, don't mind me. Alright, also close this. There. Don't want anybody following me. Come on, R6. There. Now use the key and pray that this is going to lead to, I don't know, a place that is a little safer. There. It has been opened. Oh, great. And back into the shadows. Yeah, you can stay closed. Definitely. What the hell? What is this? That is a little toy monkey. You know, the kind of monkey that claps its hands. And it's holding instruments. I don't know what you call these, but he is certainly holding them. Oh, and there is the tutorial. It shows up so rarely. Oh, I do know how to throw something. I bet I'll... Oh, I'll have to throw the monkey? What is this? Are we going to call an elevator or something? This place. I just don't know. But we are getting somewhere. This right here, this must be important. Why else would it have been locked? Just gonna push onward. And certainly nothing bad is going to happen. However, ladies and gentlemen, that would be something for next time. I hope that you enjoyed this very episode. It was kind of jump and run heavy, but hey, that is one of the things this game is all about. Certainly no danger, but danger might come for us soon. Sooner than we want, oh dear. Just be strong, Six, and we are going to believe in you. I hope that you enjoyed. My name has been the Shadow Cookie, ladies and gentlemen. Until next time, until then. Gonna be using that toy monkey to call the elevator and make a bunch of noise, even more noise. This is such a good idea.